everybody.
I'm Sam.
I'm Adam.
I'm Will. We are
Working Title.
Y'all, we are back for the exclusive Paramount Pictures miniseries, or 10-episode series, Halo.
Last on, we got the introduction to Chief in this world. People, the colonies, are not happy with the UNSC, and we met Quan Ha.
Something like that.
I think that was her name. She is a part of like a colony that is rebelling against the UNSC, and she's the only survivor in a Covenant attack. The Covenant were in search of a artifact that Chief then finds, and it makes him relive memories of his lost past.
Is it for Ryan?
Probably not, but and now Halsey and her gang are trying to protect Chief because Chief is going AWOL.
Yes. And today's episode is number 2. It is called Unbound.
So y'all, if you like the video, leave a like, hit the subscribe button and notification bell so you know when we drop more Halo reactions. Comment down below what you thought about this most recent episode. And we got a Patreon. We're watching a bunch of shows right now. Arcane, Demon Slayer. There's some Attack on Titan stuff on there, and as well as Full Metal Alchemist. If you guys want to support the channel, hit the link in the description. Help us out. Raise the channel up.
We're on the way to 50K.
Let's go!
We're so close.
And it's not a marked substitute. If y'all want to check out Halo, go on Paramount Plus first. Watch it over there. Come back to YouTube and watch your boys' reaction. We're going to punch it.
Boom! Baby.
This is what they flashed when they announced they were doing the Halo show. They showed that. Oh. Oh, never mind, it's not Chief.
Maybe a young Chief?
Oh, yeah, look at that. Damn, I kind of wish I knew my Spartan numbers to see if I can find a meal or something. Just laying next to him.
I'm not going. What are you talking about?
Oh, God.
He was trying to tell them early on, they had him brainwashed.
Didn't know those dreams we had.
Put on your mask, Soren. Put on your mask, dude.
I don't have dreams. That's what I'm here for. I'll do the dreaming for the both of us. Huh. Look, Anna's there. John, it's a fresh start.
Damn.
This place cost me my arm.
Oh, shit.
Dang, and what's good about that is you can see. If I wanted to be anyone, John.
Damn.
I wanted to be you.
Damn.
Either way, I'm a free man.
Live or die.
You've got 5 minutes. And then I'm waking up the entire camp.
Run, Soren! Come on!
Yeah, dude. Make it 10. Yeah.
He said 5. You're only getting... Man, that's kind of depressing. I've never even really thought of the Spartans that way.
Dude, I was thinking that when Keeps was hiding from the light. Like, they are property. They are not human beings. Yeah. They're science projects.
You can't even dream.
Right.
You're rejected. Also, good acting. Or good,
That guy's
that
voice.
Cast of the actor.
That guy's voice
like
sounds just like our guy, yeah.
He looks just like him, too.
A younger.
Yeah, hyperspace. Good casting. I hope Soren's still alive. That's somebody to look out for.
Space like a ball of yarn with multiple threads to the same destination.
Dude, like, shut the fuck up. Where's he going?
Don't know.
What's your answer?
How'd you make it stop the ship?
Don't know.
That's where I'm...
Don't know.
Maybe the ship's driving them somewhere, or like has a goal in mind.
How come it EMP'd everything else except his ship? It actually restarted his ship.
It is turned off.
He's gonna come back. He wouldn't just leave.
Look! Wow.
He's always got a plan.
Kai, got it. Slip space back to
Charlie.
All these orders. We'll find out when we need to.
He's got such a fucking cool voice.
It is the perfect Spartan voice.
Yeah.
Like, I feel like every Spartan should have a badass voice.
Yeah.
Master Chief ever, like, flies.
Dude, I love that there's no sound.
Oh, yeah. It sounds like it's, like, ripping through the ocean current.
Yeah.
It's so cool.
God, this guy's gonna puke. Whoa.
Holy shit.
Yeah,
it's really cool.
Yeah,
the lack of sound is awesome.
Like, oh god.
Really
he's gonna make that?
Come on. Of course he is.
Ain't the chief for nothing. Whoa.
Oh.
That makes me think the flood.
Is this like a planet?
For some reason.
Or like a city?
It's like a field belt of rocks that they're trying to keep together.
He's definitely going to see that sword, dude. There's no way we'd bring that up if he didn't.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's going to see him, you know?
It's a good call. I was kind of nervous thinking they were going to like do more flashbacks and show that he never made it off the planet or something, you know? How they always trick you like that.
Thank God they put his helmet back on.
That's not good.
She
can seal her face.
Offering cash for your head.
Damn.
Should I have not said anything?
I love the hair in the show.
Yeah.
He's got like these like
wild
cyberpunk chappa or chappy old like sci-fi hair.
Oh my god.
Nope.
Whoa.
Whoa. Oh,
that is
no,
so
no,
cool.
No. You got a lot of faith in that thing to be able to do that.
That's so awesome.
I don't have enough faith in the world to do that.
Oh.
Daddy. You got a kid.
This little guy's name is Kessler.
Soren speaks of you so often.
I was gonna say, Mutt must share stories.
Probably.
Not that often.
It was a tattoo.
Whoa!
That cool joke.
It looks so good. It looks so good.
The ring.
Watch this guy be like the Arbiter.
I was gonna say that.
Back in the day, has even an earlier encounter with the demon before we even knew it.
Come on.
Sacred ring. Yeah. I wonder if this is like what can turn it on, you know what I mean?
That's what I think it is.
Punishment not only puts him out of commission, it could be very bad for morale.
Yep.
But what good is he to the war if he can't be controlled?
Don't let him be controlled.
Actually, Abel Parangoski and I have been ahead of this for some time. I've developed a new system which will solve John's current issues. And
she's not in on it.
Expand Spartan capability across the board. It's called Cortana.
Oh!
She's like, this bitch.
Yep.
She just looped me in on this.
The Spartan bodies have been enhanced to the limits of our current technology, so Cortana will do something similar for their minds. It will override Spartan consciousness and replace it with a artificial general intelligence.
That's not what it actually does,
the first
is it?
Of its kind.
I don't know.
I mean,
it doesn't do that.
Cortana doesn't, like, control Chief.
No.
Cortana is the next stage in human evolution.
So, like, I wonder how we got from where we are in this show to, like, I know it might not be canon to, like, the games,
yeah.
But I'm still curious.
First step. The intelligence of the galaxy, in essence.
Holy shit.
With Cortana.
John, can't you replace his mind? We are talking about a person.
John is much more than a person. He is a Spartan.
Surprising coming from Keys. Didn't he just talk about killing a girl?
For us,
yeah.
John doesn't.
Yeah.
Last episode?
Do. And didn't that process depend on biological substrates? Derived from the illegal practice of flash cloning humans? That's correct.
Admiral Perengoski,
what
is your responsibility? Any advantage we can get on the covenant is a good thing. But just so we're clear.
I think the case of Master Chief provides an opportunity for a limited trial of the system. Yes.
Good. I'll leave it to you to manage the...
She's like, I cannot believe she just put me in there like that.
And if it works too, it looks good on her behalf because she's in charge of
the
operations.
Oh, we're going to see Homeboy.
Oh, boy. Oh boy, he's got hostages. Oh no.
Jeez.
Oh, this guy.
Yeah.
Remember the tale of the rebel chief.
Damn.
I know, he rhymes and he's evil.
Is that the girl's father?
And then he stole off hydrogen.
Finch hated my father.
Yep.
What is she wearing?
I know.
Do you?
Very Hunger Game
ass.
Damn. That is a view.
I gave him a day.
One gave me.
Probably a whole sack of lunch.
Yeah, bud.
5 minutes.
Sorry. We were just getting to know each other.
Us too. Did she just take a jump in heels?
Yeah.
What the fuck?
Me.
What? Oh, yeah.
I
thought it was impossible. About the treatments they gave us.
What is it? Clarity.
Clarity?
I've had enough clarity for one day. Thanks.
That's what you need to know about the Spartan program.
That's one thing, though. Calm, you know.
What they did to eliminates distractions.
Makes you numb. Makes you as numb to life as you are to the taste of this food.
It's his son.
You should be on it, man. It means he can count on you and you can count on him.
Aww. It's a smiley face there.
So fucking cute.
Thank you, Kessler. I accept.
Thank you, Kessler. I accept. Man, you are stiff.
Okay. Oh, yeah.
Mother of invention.
Stalwart dog.
What does it do?
I'm not sure.
Oh, shit, I can see a line in your eyes. How you drag this thing halfway across the galaxy because it's pretty.
Yeah.
What does it do?
It powered the ship. I saw it. Ship was dead, then he touched this thing and bam.
How? I don't know.
I don't know.
Oh! It worked for him.
He knows things.
Let's go see him.
Right.
Trust me. I want to see this dude.
This guy's probably like a hermit. It's probably a hermit.
I feel things in the sky.
Yeah, that kind
of. One last thing. No sudden moves.
I was gonna say, don't look him in the eyes.
Don't call him by his real name.
Just kidding. Man, lighten up.
Talking to a brick wall.
Oh my god, I can already tell it's gonna be.
Right. Me soaring, you there?
Stop.
Yeah.
Stop.
I brought some friends with me. I'm coming in, okay?
Wait, it's all locked. Yeah, he doesn't want to escape, it seems like.
Who's he?
This is John. This is Rhett. You come on and destroy us, do you? No.
Good!
Oh! Oh!
Oh!
Oh, shit. So Master Chief's kind of like the Lady Gaga woman in the black robes.
He just, like, forced him to use it.
At the same time the Lady Gaga lady got captured, because he said, like, you're like her or someone else.
How do you do that?
And destroy yourself.
Oh, shiz.
Oh, that's great.
Can I trust you? Of course you can.
They keep her safe.
Protect the girl.
Done.
Promise me.
Wait, hold on. Don't I get a say in this?
No.
You can't just leave me here.
He's not your daddy.
I'm sorry, Quan. This is the best I can do.
He ain't your dad. They have to be right here.
He found out something, you know, he found out about the keystone. He just wants to let y'all know now.
And he got to hide the girl. Double win.
Oh, wait, so they're already back home?
And Silver Team. Because didn't Silver Team bear guns at the military?
Yeah. No, they're the ones that are just looking for him on the ship.
Yeah, but still. Like
they take direct orders from Halsey, that's it.
But they never saw... Yeah, so he's in cuffs.
Okay.
They never knew that's what actually they were doing.
Okay.
They didn't get a chance to...
I wasn't sure if they were all going to be put in cuffs because of it.
The MP went off before they could do anything.
Sure.
Are they talking to each other? You hear that noise? What the fuck is that?
Maybe just him, like, recognizing where it's at.
I do wish Silver Team had a lot of color on its armor, but whatever.
Yeah.
At least they're Spartans. I like their colored visors, though. Dark red, bright blue.
Yeah.
Yeah, man.
Maybe this helps make Cortana, like, engages it to the next level.
Yeah, man. As I was about to say, she walks in that room smiling.
I know, right?
All the details of the images that I see
I didn't know. I don't think that's a constructive place for us to go. I think we should focus on the lab results.
He's gonna wanna know, though. He's gonna wanna know.
What was it about the girl that made you run?
Didn't wanna kill her?
You're about to get naked. I feel like that's something this show's just gonna drop randomly.
Well, I don't think the situation was different. I think I am
different.
Different.
Ooh.
It's like your sister over here.
She can have the scars too.
What it is?
Doesn't look like
chose me.
Oh, snap! Look at you.
I know it's out there.
Whoa.
Then why did you come back?
Because it's the right thing to do.
Have your backs.
There's no one else I could trust.
Thank you. You made the right choice.
And now she's gonna brainwipe you and be like, make him not a human being anymore.
Hopefully not.
That's what she wants to do. Unless that's a lie to the council and it's just really an AI that's with her.
I see this.
Yeah,
with the beginning.
She seems like a schemer anyway, so she might end up deciding it's in best interest for him to keep his memories, what little it may be. It might even help with the process of partnering with an AI too. To have some human part about you instead of just being incomplete.
Sus, man.
It's kind of creepy, man. I don't like that.
That was episode 2. So I will drop this because everyone said it in our comments. I've also seen like conversation about this, that this show uses the same ideas and characters, but it's not necessarily like the canon like Halo universe.
So they're gonna take some liberties and switch up the story a bit to make it maybe spontaneous for viewers who've already shared the story or like experienced the story.
Yeah.
Well, honestly, I mean,
no problem.
I said it off camera. And even if it's not the consensus out there in the world, I'm actually pretty excited for the show. What directions it may take, even if it's not like what the Halo fans want. I mean, I'm a Halo fan too. Like, I don't want to disregard my own experience and act like it's not worthy of having an opinion too, because I love the Halo story. And I'm digging the show. I'm not gonna lie. Even if people aren't feeling it, I'm feeling it already.
Yeah.
I am.
I'm
like,
enjoying
it. I don't want to act like I'm not enjoying it, because I do enjoy this,
yeah.
Actually.
I mean, I think this was far better than the last episode. I mean, granted, we didn't get, like, any action.
Yeah.
But the drama of this episode was 1,000 times better than
last. I was going to say, it's really starting to build for something.
And we were just on IMDb. I was trying to see if it was actually the actor, the madman, was the same actor. It wasn't, but the review for the episode was a 7.1, so... I mean, I personally disagree. I do disagree. I think this was a pretty solid second follow-up episode. I think it was better than the first one as well. I felt the relationships with the characters a bit more, which is surprising because Master Chief is a brick wall. But you can already start to see the humanity like kind of kick in. I think the guy who plays Shocker helped that a lot, like
kind of
testing who the Master Chief is and like how he might have been somebody beforehand. Before the programming took over.
Yeah.
But it's kind of cool, because you don't get that... I mean, you get bits and fragments of iconic lines from Master Chief in the games, but other than his actions, which are always in a bodysuit, you never really get to see any emotional stakes in his face. He always is just kind of the good guy, and you just know he's a good guy. So to see it kind of in this perspective is kind of cool, to know that he didn't start that way in this new canon. So.
Yeah.
He was so focused on the kid. I don't know if you guys saw that.
Mm-hmm. He cares for her.
No. Soren's kid. He was so curious about him.
Well, just the difference of a personality. I mean, he has no... It's almost like starting at scratch as a child because he has to relearn everything. When you're programmed, I mean, they said you don't have senses, lack of taste, probably doesn't even understand the enjoyment of music or... the physical touch of someone else in his life.
And just by his shock at him having a kid, I guess they can't reproduce either.
Maybe not. I don't know.
Yeah.
Maybe it's something that comes later. They make them, like, unable to produce once you hit a certain point in being a Spartan. Maybe they haven't fully gone into the process of being... I don't know what, like, becoming a Spartan looks like. If it's, like, tears that you have to, like, slowly incorporate into your physical body, but...
Yeah, I'm not sure.
Definitely,
I mean,
those scars, though.
Yeah. I mean, I would just say, like... Just based off what the show is, I would just be like, anything we know, I would just toss it out. Other than the
Fair
fact
enough.
Of characters and what exactly they do, I would say it's probably not even worth, like... There's a fucking human on the Covenant side. I mean, like, I just feel...
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, I just think that, like, even trying to, like, compare to the games in a sense of, like, what certain characters do and how they act and, like, what
mm-hmm.
they are... a part of, it's, like, not even necessarily, like, worth it. So,
well, it may be a good starting place for conversation, for sure.
No, it's definitely a good... I'm just saying that this show just, like... I feel like this show has enough to just be on its own. You know what I mean? Like,
true.
Like, the whole... Like, I have no idea. I don't know if Spartans can reproduce or not, but enough that, like, the whole, like, beads or pills in their back that they have that's... Pellets, yeah, that, like, suppress their hormones and stuff like that. I mean, that alone probably would hinder their reproductive capabilities.
Or enhances their hormones. That dude is big compared to Soren. Soren's, like... I mean, Master Chief looks like he's 7 foot up into 8 foot, and that guy looks like he's no taller than me. Like, maybe 6'5", I don't know.
Yeah.
Well, I'm still gonna ask my questions.
Let's
no, I'm not saying you,
okay?
I'm not saying you can't ask your questions. I'm just saying that.
Well, you said it's not worth asking them, so I'm gonna ask it. Okay.
Ask it.
Okay.
Who made the Halo rings?
The Forerunners.
Yeah. I'm not too learned. I don't know.
And their sole purpose is destroy planets.
No, they wipe out life. They don't destroy
just life?
Planets. They just wipe out life.
Okay. Yeah.
It's like a reset on humanity itself. Like, I think, like, that kind of stuff, I don't think they'll change. I'm not saying they're going to bring up Forerunners in the show, but I'm saying I don't think they're going to change, like, the simple understanding. Like, they brought up the Great Journey, they brought up that the Covenant want the Halo Ring, they brought up the Halo Ring that's a weapon. Like, I think that kind of stuff that's is going to be solid, set in place. I just think, like, little things of, like even the question of, like, how are Spartans made? Do they, is there a process? Is it, like, a one-off, like, you just did this procedure and then they're that? Like a Witcher from, you know, the Witcher series? Or is it, like, a every stage they have to do something, like, for stuff like those kind of questions and, like, characters' backstories a little bit more or their inner relationships, I think that we'll have to just, like, take from the show what they give us at that point. But I think, like, the overarching things of, like, a warthog is a gun, is a truck with a gun on the back of it. Like, that's going to be the same no matter what. Halo rings, wipe out life.
We'll have to see. I know, even if they do take liberties, they might do some strong comparisons as well. I mean, we're only two episodes in, and unless people have, like, cheated and looked at, like, interviews from, like, a year ago, then the audience will have to find out, too.
Yeah.
We don't know.
Yeah.
They might pull a, it might pull a red herring and have some comparisons at the end.
Yeah.
I got vibes of the episode where we find out about the Fuhrer from Full Metal from this episode with how, like, I'm wondering what if they're like test subjects, so what if they just get to a point where it's like they do something and they become a Spartan and it's just like, ah, you failed. Goodbye.
Like, in the process of becoming a Spartan, if they don't live up to a certain standard, they get offed?
Yeah.
Is that what you're believing happened to Soren? Or, like...
No, just Spartans in general with the whole program.
Well, I guess we'll have to... That's definitely going to be one of those we have to find out.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Because I do not know.
Yeah.
It seems like from Soren's perspective, just starting the episode, he just might have been more self-aware of what was happening. He might have been fighting... He might have been fighting the dreams that were disappearing, or... Maybe new dreams being implemented in his mind that were not his own.
They're supposed to, like, take a pill, and he hasn't been taking it.
Or something
like
that,
that
too. Yeah.
He stayed woke. He was he kept that third eye open. He wasn't listening to what the man was saying.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
He might have been more aware in the process, and it could have been like the mental asylums in the 60s. Like, you take a pill to forget what's occurring, and then you fall into a process, and maybe Soren just didn't conform and realized something might have been shady off the bat. Didn't take those morning pills and started to realize they're kind of doing something to us. I think I went out.
This makes me also think of... It was like the 2010s, 2015s. They were doing the young, like, Hunger Games and... what is that? Runner. Maze Runner. Those kind of movies. There was a movie where they took the color out of the world.
The Giver.
Yeah.
That's a movie I actually just watched a month ago. Like,
what if Chief doesn't see color?
He might not.
Yeah.
I mean, we don't know what that means or what that entails, but we can at least gather from this episode no taste.
Yeah.
And no understanding of, like, simple human
interactions. He doesn't have
feelings.
Emotions.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He doesn't have feelings or, like, opinions on things. Like, he is just like, this is what
he's
numb.
Is.
Yeah.
Ironically, he's still skeptical, though, because he didn't want to share what the weapon did.
Well, but that's because he's starting to
have
feel.
Those come
yeah.
in.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
True. My knowledge of Halo is I've only played from 3 to 4. So
3 to 4? You didn't play 1 and 2?
No, I did not.
Oh. You didn't play those.
Are the Forerunners in 3 Reach and 4 or no?
It's 4. 4. I mean, you don't...
I barely remember the fourth game.
Yeah. I mean, I don't remember exactly. It's just one of those things where, like, they're not relevant until they dealt with the Covenant. And then they dealt with the Covenant, it's like, oh shit, there's
bigger threats out there. Yeah.
You beat Loki, and then you're like, oh shit, there's Thanos.
Okay.
Yeah, so...
So not much is known about the Forerunners?
I don't remember.
Okay.
Like, those games were a blur to me. It was more of an objective of beating it on the hardest difficulty. Like, I didn't really glean from, like, the story much of it at all.
Yeah. So... The start of the episode was the Soren encounter
flashback with
John. We got to see him as a young guy. Damn good casting from young adult to what we have now.
Yeah.
Same with Soren. Good casting all around. We already kind of touched on that, like Soren just being a little bit more woke to things and Chief kind of being very strict about you only get 5 minutes.
Well, they also, you know, don't forget this part, he was on board with leaving with him at first, too.
Yeah, almost.
Like, he was ready to go with him. And for whatever reason, he changed his mind and decided that this is wrong. We need to stay behind, you know, stay with us.
And he kept that opinion, too, later in the episode. He still, when they parted ways, he was still pretty adamant about, we have to return to them.
Yeah.
Like, you betrayed us.
Yeah.
Like, I'm still returning to them, which is, I wonder if that's Chief talking, programmed Chief, or if this is John's opinion, like you're saying. Like, if he's starting to develop an opinion, like, this is what he truly believes is still maybe the right thing.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know.
And also a little bit of background, Soren has his arm really fucked up from whatever Halt, like,
yeah.
whatever his training slash what Halsey did. I mean, literally it looked like it was like that he had like a metal implant through his, like, I don't know.
It might be a
deformed
rod.
Arm. Or, you know, I don't know what happened or what injury he sustained, but he blamed Halsey for it specifically.
And then while he was on the run, he got even worse. He said he got burned up and shot.
Yeah.
But we go to,
it was probably, we briefly were back on Reach and we got to see, Lord Hood.
Yeah.
Talking to Halsey. And I don't know if it's making it in the reaction, but I'm pretty positive that's the guy I was confused with thinking Keys last episode as the guy from the intro to Halo 2 that puts the badges on Johnson and Master Chief.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I feel like from memory, they're both old white guys, so
they were.
It's kind of like, that makes sense why we got them confused.
Yeah.
But yeah, Hood basically was like, Halsey, do you have a plan? Because we can't really just like toss aside Chief. And she's like, yep, I do. I was like, alright, cool, keep it simple. Bring it up with the committee, they should know about it, and then we'll figure out from there. Mm-hmm. And then we got Chief flying in the flying through space, which is really cool. That whole, like, hyperspace travel.
I love the sounds it makes. Yeah. It literally is like when you take your hand underwater and you close, like, you go under with it and then you brush it across against the force of the wave.
Yeah.
Or just even a pool, just a flat water just kind of sitting still.
Yeah.
Very minimal sound.
And then they landed and he brought Quan and the Keystone on to meet with Soren.
I think the planet was called Rubble.
Yeah, the Rubble.
Rubble.
Very cool design.
Yeah. It kind of reminded me of, what is that place called in Guardians of the Galaxy 2 that's in the
giant head.
Yeah, the head of the, like, the Titans.
Oh, yeah.
Nowhere?
Nowhere, yeah.
Nowhere.
It kind of reminded me of Nowhere.
That's how I felt, too. Especially once you got into the inside with the little ride that, like, jumped on the wire and they're going through there. That's how the Nowhere looks as well.
Yeah. Also, another random one, but in Star Wars, the
Caffeine or something.
Yeah,
Rogue One.
Yeah, I don't remember what it's called. It's like an asteroid where.
Yeah, I think it's two asteroids, and the city goes in between it.
Yeah,
I think it's how.
But you're literally just like out, like walking around, and you can see space like above you and the stars and everything.
And they're just sharing ideas between one another.
Yeah. But yeah, they got on, and then everyone clearly did not want him there because he was a Spartan, probably thinking that he was doing, you know, there for UNSC business. Ran into Soren, and they went back with Soren to his place.
Yeah. Got to meet a wife and a child
to
Chief's surprise. A wife who's also experienced the trauma of war and the Covenant's impact. Which resonated with Quan when they were looking at the crazy Nazi guy out in the desert popping people in the head.
Yeah.
I don't even know. He's so weird.
Yeah, I mean, apparently he was on their side, like the rebellion side, but he wanted to strike a deal with the UNSC to make themselves money.
Yep.
And didn't like Quan's father, so.
Yeah. I think that's kind of when we got into, like, who John is and the lack of what
he feels and is, yeah.
Very cool design. Just real quick on just the set pieces this today's episode. Really incredible. Like, they really they made you feel like you were on a little colony. And not to jump into other universes, but I love in sci-fi in general when they go, like, really rustic and rocky with, like, colony settings. Like, I think that's always, like, a great way to establish where you are in the universe. It just has a certain feel about it that feels like, okay, this is real sci-fi.
Yeah.
It made me think of the Chronicles of Riddick movie. There's, like, a prison planet.
Prison colonies are very common. Yeah. I mean, the Alien series has them. Yeah. I think the third film is a prison colony. You just get that a lot. And it works, too, because it's such a weird thing for space films, because space is so vast. To think that you have to have, like, whole colonies just for, like, prison planets. I know this is not a prison planet specifically.
Yeah.
But, like, it's just so weird.
Yeah. We also got to see the Blessed One. Now we have, like, kind of, like, a name for her. Talking to the three prophets and the elite that witnessed what Chief was able to do. He was able to describe that he saw the Halo ring being projected from the Keystone, and that he was able to access it just like she should be able to.
Yeah.
That's one thing I'm so, like, has she touched, like, special artifacts before and they've, like, lit up and done things? Like, how do they know that she's, like, capable? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But
there's definitely been some weird encounter.
Yeah, I mean, like, I'm sure that she's, because the later on, Reth talks about that the Blessed One can interact with the objects. I'm just curious, like, what other objects? Like, why is this one different?
Yeah.
More special from that?
I mean, I guess that's kind of like the next part of the plot anyway, because the conversation leads to, here's this object, what is it? I don't know, but it's from this group of people. I have a buddy who's experienced the Covenant. He might have a deeper knowledge on these type of things. And they go to the Looney House with people that might bite you. And a man who's in a cage that's not locked, so he's not trying to go anywhere.
His name's Reth.
And he's a little bit funky looking, but he has some deep lore.
He escaped from the Covenant before. Also, just to bring up one last part, the girl, she wants to go retrieve the Keystone herself.
Oh, yeah.
Which she, they were not super willing to let her go as, like, their prized possession. But she was like, you saved me, you taught me about the Great Journey, like, let me go do this. And it seems like they are allowing her to go ahead. But yeah, so Reth was captured by Covenant before, somehow managed to survive. It looked like they tried to see... He said he was sensitive, but not sensitive enough to use it. So I don't know how they, like, detect that there are these humans that can perceive it.
He said they asked me to test it.
Well, I get that, but, like, you just randomly grab a human and say, fuck it. You know what I mean? But they said he was sensitive enough, but not, like, not Blessed One sensitive.
He made it seem like it was, like, random. Like, he's like, it's just the... did he use amino acids?
He was describing humans. He was like,
it might be a different.
What are humans? Homo sapiens? Just amino acids thrown together. He was just rambling, saying, like,
random selection of specials.
Yeah, or, like, is there more to it than just us being, like, random genetics and, you know, proteins and fats and everything together?
Whoever is the Blessed One has, like, an innate desire to
awaken it.
Not just awaken, but, like, they have a goal in life. Like, a very strong, like, almost, like, fated destiny in store for them.
Yeah.
Whether it's saving the world or destroying it, being the one to literally activate it.
Yeah.
Which might be what this object does, is turn on the ring.
Yeah, I feel like it's gotta be, since its whole thing is, like, EMP power.
It's a pretty damn strong thing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's why I still think it's weird that... it just powered up his shit and shut off everything else. I think that's weird.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mind of its own.
Mm-hmm.
Better not touch it. Yeah, so, just real quick also on the Blessed One and the random elite. I think it would be cool, just story, even if it's not the Arbiter, like, if it is, like, a character from the enemy side that we get to, like, in time and in passing become a general, then, like, the war chief, and, like, maybe we get to have a enemy rise in the story to combat Chief, maybe as, like, a boss eventually one day.
Yeah.
I think that'd be cool. Like, just a guy who continuously survives battles that we encounter on the good guy team.
Yeah.
I think that's cool in storytelling, if you can have a two-way road for heroes on opposing sides.
They should have made it the elite that called him Demon.
Was it not him?
No. This is the one that was just randomly hiding at the place.
And I happened to see him.
Adam, stop messing with that thing.
I'm sorry.
Pay attention to the conversation.
Really quick, what do you think the scars are on her back? What does that signify? No idea.
Maybe she was in the Spartan program.
They didn't look similar. They looked more like, I know this is really stupid, I have no reason to say this. I just feel like it was more of like a plasma scar because it was like, it seemed like it was like multicolored. It could have just been the room lighting, but like...
It was like random too.
It looked, and it was only in one spot where like John's are on his shoulder pads and then like the bottom of his neck or his shoulder blades.
Like, it's more like incisions on him, like intentional things to enhance or deteriorate.
Hers almost looked like a branding almost, like just like she got stuck with something.
Yeah.
Maybe that's the connection. Maybe there's something unlocked in her and him, but then why didn't it do it for other Spartans? You know, who knows?
Have other Spartans touched the object? Do we know?
Soren did.
Yeah.
Maybe, once again, maybe he didn't get far enough into a procedure that it would make him special enough or blessed enough.
Yeah. I mean, they made it seem... Wrath makes it seem like there's something super, super special about John. Also, super random, too. The fact that he could tell that he had seen the Covenant before was, like, really weird. And Quan as well, because he was pretty obsessed with Quan.
He knew her last name before she could say it. She said, "My name's Quan," and he goes, "Quan, huh?"
Mm-hmm. Interesting.
Yeah.
Maybe a sightseer, or a green seer.
Yeah.
Can, like, tap into waves and channels that we cannot access after experiences.
And then we had the council, the committee meeting.
Right.
Basically, they talked about they put the dude in power on Madripoor, and now he's on their side brokering a deal. Deuteronomy, whatever the fuck it's called, is the prices for the fuel from that are cheaper now, so they're making money and kind of getting the rebellion off their backs. And the colonies, trying to get them, like, in the fold. They're saying other colonies were taking notice as well.
I did love today where, like, what was the lady's name? We got the name for her.
Paganoski?
Yeah.
The ski lady. Yeah. I love that, like, they went to our Halsey and asked if there was, like, an option. And didn't she, like, say, like, haven't you been using, like, isn't that, like, an illegal way to do it? And she was like, yeah, and they're like, so how's it going? Like, is it going well? Like, there's no, like...
Well,
like,
they asked...
Have you figured out a way?
Around it.
Yeah. Yeah, so have you figured out a way around the illegal part?
The cloning part. They want to work around
it. They call it flash cloning. Yeah. I don't know what that means. Or, like, if that's different than regular cloning, or, like, what?
And then I just, like, the focus went, like, all right, well, you're the chief ski woman, whatever her name
chief
is.
Ski.
What is, chief ski? We'll call her that for now. Chief ski, what are your thoughts? And then she, like... kind of is like putting her chips on Halsey that she's gonna be successful and hopefully get the benefit of.
Yeah. Well, she said Master Chief gives a limited chance for. Gives us an opportunity to limitedly test this or whatever.
Trial and error.
Yeah.
See if it works.
But yeah, Halsey played her like a fiddle and brought up the Cortana program to link together AI and Spartan physique so that. Basically, the AI's perfect mind replaces the Spartans. So, it sounds kind of fucked up. Because even Keyes was like, they're human, like, too. Like, we can't just...
He's more than human.
And she said he's more than
Spartan.
Human. He's a Spartan.
Mr. Keyes now taking the moral high ground out of nowhere.
Yeah, after wanting to kill a kid.
Yeah.
I did, like, his little look over at Halsey, though, like, what are you doing, girl?
Yeah, well, that's why I was confused. I'm like, is he playing along in this of like being like, oh, but he's a human too, and then she like does that because at the end of the episode when she's getting, you know, Praganowski or whatever involved, he gives this like smirk to her, like he looks inside like that's my girl, like
I forget that their child is
Miranda.
Yeah,
that's cool. Mother like daughter.
Yeah. Next thing, too, is Miranda was talking to Praganowski about, hey, I don't get it. Why does Halsey get all this? Like, she takes all the research funding. She gets all the stuff to fund her Spartans while I've helped make, you know, camo, space travel stuff, other shit that nobody cares about.
Yeah.
And then she's just like sitting there. She's like, but come on. I have great research. Why don't you trust me too? And the lady was like,
I put you there.
She's like, I put you there and I'm done being manipulated today. Leave me alone. Go back to work. I really don't like her.
I don't like her either.
Miranda.
You don't like Miranda?
Oh, Miranda.
No.
Oh, I like her. I think she's just a little too, like, new.
She's angsty.
She's too new.
Yeah.
I mean, I can see the potential there. She's not as annoying as the
Bois-ski
lady. I don't like her.
But I think she's intentionally supposed to be annoying.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, she's supposed to be annoying. I don't think Miranda's supposed to be annoying. She's coming up. She's like, hey, I knew that your whole family was murdered, but join us to help the greater cause.
She just seems a little too unprofessional for the job that's there.
If you don't get the fuck out of my face, like, right now, like, I just don't know. Like,
I think
she seems weird.
The naivety of, like, her personality compared to all the adults.
Yeah.
Like, she's, like, our age, hanging out with, like, a bunch of, like, 40 to 50-year-olds, and it just feels a little bit, like, what are you doing here? You
just
agree.
Feels like nerdy know-it-all, trying to save the world, super optimistic, never really realize that anything bad in life's going on. She's like,
Speaking of performances, I think the acting was better this episode today.
Yeah.
Even with Halsey.
A lot better.
What'd you guys think of Sounds this episode? There wasn't a whole lot, like you said, it wasn't an action episode. There wasn't a whole lot of, like, crazy music.
It's hard because we use subtitles.
We use subtitles, so I feel like a lot of the stuff that there were definitely moments in the show. I can't think of the exact scene off the top of my head, but there was a moment where I think it was mostly the couple times Lord Hood talked. Sorry, when he was on the balcony, he kept saying things, and I was like reading the word, and like, that does not sound like what he just said. That reading that word does not sound like what he just said.
Yeah, so, I would quickly. I think I was able to listen to most of it, but anytime I thought I was hearing something, I would just look down and subtitle correct.
When they were going to see Reth, there was a moment I couldn't hear Soren talk.
Yeah.
From what was happening in the background.
I didn't try too hard to listen to what Reth had to say. I just enjoyed listening to
it. Horn. They were on their way to him. They were just walking and talking, and there was a moment, like, it was right before he went to get the churros. He said something to the chief, and I didn't catch it. I couldn't hear it.
Yeah.
From all the noise in the background. Yeah.
Yeah, there are definitely moments where I was like, meh. Like, I think it's not as bad as when we were using our other thing, whatever it was, but, like, it just doesn't. It's not as bad, but it's still like, meh. I don't know. When I was editing, I was listening to part of the episode. Like, when I was recording it, I had, like, my headphones next to me, and I would, like, chime in just to, like, see. And it still wasn't, like, that great. It wasn't as bad, but it wasn't that great.
Yeah.
So,
not everybody's great at sound mixing, I suppose. I don't know.
Fucking Paramount.
Yeah.
Pay somebody. Plenty of good engineers out there. You can pull.
We got names for the Spartans. I think Kai is one of them. Kai.
Vanek.
And, like, Riz.
Riz. Okay.
Vanek
is the guy.
Kai
is the whiter lady. And then Riz
is
like the
ginger,
redheaded, lighter
girl.
Skin woman.
Yeah.
Okay. Gotta remember that. Those are kind of wacky names.
Kai, Riz, Vanek. Yeah. I don't know. That dude is like the most Spartan other than Chief that you could get.
Who's the new guy in the games? Is it Locke?
Locke.
Yeah.
Kind of reminds me of him a little bit.
I didn't play 5 enough to really remember. I mean, I know he's Luke Cage, so I have Luke Cage to go off of. But, like, most of the Reach voices I can hear in my head. I can hear Chief, obviously. I can hear Nathan Fillion, just because it's Nathan Fillion. I know he's, like, one of the newer Spartans, the ODST guy, but...
They made him a Spartan?
Well, he was one of the ODST characters.
I don't understand if he's a Spartan or if he's just a Marine that's on the Spartan squad with Locke, but he's in Locke's squad.
Yeah, I might be wrong about that. In my head canon, because I knew he was in the ODST game, I just assumed maybe they turned him into a Spartan because he was a successful Marine or something.
Yeah,
I could be wrong about that, so don't grill me, but what was the reason I brought that up? What were we talking about?
The three Spartans remembering their names.
Oh, and I like Venek's voice. I think he has a standout voice that will probably be remembered by the end of this.
That's a cool name too.
I know that they're silver team. I just want them to have some like
color
on their armor.
Well, it's weird.
I don't like the blank
they gave
canvas.
Chief green. I was like, why wouldn't you just give the other guys like standard like blue, red, and like You could even give the other one, like, Brown or something. Like, it wouldn't be that big a deal.
Is he only the pseudo-leader? Like, they just brought him on because Silver Team needed, like, a head of staff. And so Chief is from a group that has colored armor. Because, I mean, look at these guys. They got awesome looks. Even, I mean, Emil's the most, like, Silver Team. No, he's the most Silver Team looking, but he's got the big shoulder and the skull that makes him a standout. Mm-hmm. But I think they need some colors to the show.
Yeah.
The show's a little 2D saturated for my liking. Like color wise, but
I see. Yeah, I can see that.
The only other thing, and it's just a random side note, has nothing to do with the grand scheme. I did like the space travel. It reminded me a lot of Endgame because Endgame used a lot of purples and pinks in the space scenery, especially with like Iron Man and Nebula when they were sitting in space. I like that they just chose those colors for this.
It's good
area.
It's a good color combo.
Yeah.
I mean, you always get like blues in Star Wars for space travel or like bright whites.
But Chief left Quan behind.
Yeah.
Got Soren to he trusted Soren with protecting her. He left her, and then he went back to join up with the other Spartans. Silver Team lit up his beacon, and then they took him in, cuffed him, and brought him back to Reach.
Yeah.
Halsey took the Keystone, and then she and Chief had a sit down conversation, trying to talk about what happened, why it happened. She wouldn't go down the path to talk about his memories, his images in his head. She's like, I don't think that's worth going over. And he was like, okay. And just kept it moving, yeah. Pushed that shit to the side. And then she asked Chief, like, why did you protect the girl? And it was like, I don't know. We, like, just felt it was
the right thing.
And she's kind of like, interesting. And, they're unlocking Cortana.
Yeah.
And trying to get her active as the next step in human evolution.
I'm curious to see how that's going to go, because right now Cortana looks nothing like Cortana. A bald-headed Halsey.
She's also like a body.
I was going to say, yeah, she's not a hologram.
It could just be the first phase.
She's not blue.
We will see.
Unless she hooks herself up, like, she, like, sits in a chair and, like, hooks herself up into Chief's head. Like, here's my Wi-Fi chip. Plug in.
I did thoroughly enjoy Halsey talking to Chief in the cell.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
You could see why they chose her for being Cortana for his Chief. Like, you can see the future chemistry of the two.
Yeah.
Even though it's Halsey, like, it's the same actress. So, realistically, it's going to be her in Chief's HUD for the rest of whatever story, if it's anywhere close to our video games.
Yeah. That'd be cool if they throw iron like that.
Yeah.
And then we saw the Blessed One getting naked.
Dope.
Getting ready to leave. Cool.
I'm very curious about her like side story.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I just love how all those aliens look. That was probably the best CG for the show
so
far.
It's really good.
I love like the white tentacle.
Yeah, you saw that?
Frame behind them.
Yeah.
It looked like it was, like, biotic, like, moving on its own.
It's like we're on Kamino.
Or even, like, when the shot with the our elite were following, like, black paneled lines far in the distance behind him in, like, a dome room.
Yeah.
That was really cool. And I really like that they have their own speech. I really think that's cool. I think that adds a layer that, like, I don't want to hear them speak in English, honestly.
Yeah.
Maybe if they do like a little Star Trek translation, like they pop a chip in and all of a sudden they can talk and we hear them in English, I'll believe it, whatever, just for storytelling. But I like that it's like a language barrier right now.
Yeah. It's something they can like work out later on.
Alright, Arbiter, it's time to learn your ABCs.
Demon.
Yeah. I'm ready for episode 3.
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
Me too.
Y'all, if you enjoy this reaction, if you enjoy this series, if you enjoy our post-talk, leave a like, subscribe to the channel, check out the Patreon, support us by also going to watch the first episode, or watch some of our other live-action shows. I think we've done Squid Games, Vikings, more in the future, and for the time being, we'll see you in episode 3. Honche!
Bow!
I guess the Marvel, because that is also live-action.